Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Kerala Comes in this school Mudol online classes. In previous class we completed 7th problem of exercise 2.5. So today we will continue with 8th problem of exercise 2.5. So here in 8th problem what they have given, Shyam brought 5 kg 300 gram apples and 3 kg 250 gram mangoes. Sarala brought 4 kg 800 gram orange and 4 kg 150 gram bananas. Who brought more fruits? So first we'll write what they have brought. First, Shyam brought 5 kg 300 grams apples next we got 3 kg 250 grams mangoes 3 kg 250 So Shyam brought 5 kg 300 grams apples and 3 kg 250 grams mangoes here. So now I will add these two values. Okay. So here 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 5, 5. 3 plus 2, 5. Next, this is gram value. Next, 5 plus 3, 8. 8 kg, 550 grams. Okay. So now, one more question. Sarala brought 4 kg 800 gram oranges. 4 kg 800 grams oranges. Okay. Now again she got 4 kg 150 grams. 4 kg 150 grams. What she got? Bananas. So how much she brought totally? 0. I will add now. 0 plus 0, 0. 0 plus 5, 5. 8 plus 1, 9. 950 grams. Here, 4 plus 4, 8. So now you can check what they asked here. Shyam brought 5 kg 300 grams apples, 2 kg 250 grams mangoes. Means totally brought. When you add these two values, what you got here? 8 kg 550 grams of fruits. Shyam brought 8 kg 550 grams of fruits. Now you can see here, Sarala brought 4 kg 800 grams oranges and 4 kg 150 grams bananas. So when you add these two, what you get? 8 kg 950 grams of fruits. Sarala brought 8 kg 950 gram fruits. So now here they are asking who brought more fruits. They are asking who brought more fruits. Means we have to compare these two values. So now 8 kg 550 grams, here we got 8 kg 950 grams. Okay, so how to compare these two values? I will convert these values to decimal number. So first I will convert this to decimal number. 8 kg 550 grams means I will convert it to kg. So 8 plus 550 grams means, while converting to grams, sorry, kg, what we have to do? 550 divided by 1000, because you all know 1 kg equals to 1000 grams. So 550 by 1000. So 8 plus 550 divided by 1000 means, you have to write this 550 in 1 by 1000 position. Okay, so what you will get? 8 by, because here we got 550 by 1000 means we have to write 550 1 by 1000 position. So 8 point, what we can write? 8.550 kg. Okay, here you can see after decimal point 1 by 10th position, 1 by 100th position, after that you can put 0. So 8.550 kg you can write. Now here again 8 kg 950 grams, I will convert it to kg. So 8 plus 950 grams means, while converting it to kg, 950 divided by 1000, again what you will get? 8.950 kg. Okay, so now you can compare these two values. So while comparing decimal numbers, how to compare? First we should compare leftmost number of decimal point. Leftmost number of decimal point means left part of the decimal point is 8 here. Here left part of the decimal number, here also it is 8. So here these two values are same. Now we have to compare first digit of the right part of the decimal point. Right part of the decimal point means this 550 950, and here first digit is 5 and here first digit is 9. So we know that this 9 is greater than 5, so that we can say that 8.950 is greater than 8.550. Why? Here you can see this part 9 is greater than 5, therefore below this it is right. Sarala brought more proof. Okay, see here, we are given Sham brought this much apple and this much mangoes. So we have to add these two values, and after getting this we have to convert it to kg. We are given kg and gram also, so we have to compare these two values. We have to convert this to kg. To convert, what we can do? 8 kg means this is already in kg, so I will write directly 8 only, plus 550 grams, means I have to convert this gram to kg. So 550 by 1000 I have to write, because 1 kg equals to 1000 grams. So 550 by 1000 means what you get? 0.550. so 8 plus 0.550 means what you get? 8.550 kg. Okay, here 1 by 1000 position, first we have written 5, after that 5, 1 by 10, 1 by 1000, and first we will get 1 by 10th position. Here we get 1 by 10th position, first digit is 5, next digit is 5, so this is 1 by 100th position, next is 0, this is 1 by 1000th position. So 550 by 1000 means 0.550. So when you add 8 plus 0.550, what you get? 8.550 kg. So now again Sarala brought this much of oranges and this much bananas. So you have to add these two values, and
you have to convert this value to kg. Already they have given 8 kg, so I will write 8 only plus 950 grams. I have to convert this 950 to kg. So 950 divided by 1000 I will write here. Again, you have to remember that 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams. So 950 by 1000. So when you convert this 950 by 1000 to decimal number, what it becomes? 0.950, because here we have 1000th position. Now here also at 1 by 10th position we will write first digit 9, next 1 by 100th position next digit is 5, next position is 1 by 1000th position, so here we will get 0. Okay. So now you know how to compare two decimal numbers. So here you can see 8.550 and 8.950. So while comparing two decimal numbers, first we should compare left part of the decimal point. Left part of the decimal point. Here it is 8 and here also it is 8, means both the numbers are same. After that, you can check with first number or first digit of the right part of the decimal point. Here right part of the decimal point, first digit is 5 is here and here it is 9. And you know that this 9 is greater than 5, so that this 8.950 is greater than 8.550. Okay. So if this 8.950 is greater than this value, then Sarala brought more fruits than Shyam. Okay. Now I will continue with next problem, 9th one. So here in 9th column what have given, how much less is 28 km than 42.6 km?
9th column, which is last problem in exercise 9.5. So that they have given how much less than 28 km? 28 km. Then 42.6 km. 42.6 km. They are asking here directly how much less this 28 km, how much less than 42.6 km. So what we have to do here? Directly we have to subtract. So 42.6 minus 28, means I can write it as 28.0. Okay, what they are asking, how much less this 28 km is, how much less than the 42.6 km. So we have to subtract. So first I will write 42.6 km minus this 28 can be written as 28.0, because this will be easy for us to subtract 6 minus 0. Okay, or you can write it as 28 only, so you can directly write 6, but here in the place of 28 I have written 28.0. so there is no change, both are same, 28 and 28.0. so 6 minus 0 means what you will get? 6. After this one decimal point is there, so I will put one decimal point. Next 2 minus 8, so I will consider one carry here. 12 minus 8 means what you will get? 12 minus 8 means 4. Okay. So next 4 minus 3, because one carry is here, so 4 minus 3 means 1. So 14.6 kilometers. 14.6 kilometers. So that below this you should write here 28 kilometers. This 28 kilometer is 14.6 kilometer less than 42.6 kilometers. Okay. So here this 28 kilometer is 14.6 kilometer less than 42.6 kilometer. So this completes exercise 2.5. Okay. So now I will continue with multiplication of decimal numbers.
I hope you are clear with all these problems of exercise 2.5. Solve all the problems of exercise 2.5. Already I solved most of the problems from this exercise. Try to solve remaining 2 to 3 problems and solve example problems also. So now I will continue with multiplication of decimal numbers. So here they have given values that 0.1 into 0.1. So you know what is decimal number. So we will see how to multiply decimal numbers. So here they have given an example 0.1 into 0.1. Okay. So now this 0.1 can be converted to fractional number also. So here they have written that 0.1 into 0.1 means this can be written as 1 by 10. 0.1 can be written as 1 by 10, because you can see here after this decimal point only one digit is there, means this is at the position 1 by 10. Okay, listen carefully. After this decimal point only one digit is there, so this is at the position 1 by 10, and 1 means 1 is there at the position 1 by 10, so you can directly write 1 by 10 like this. This only, this 0.1 can be written as 1 by 10 only. Okay, so now we will multiply. 1 into 1 means what you get? 1. 10 into 10 means what you get? 100. So 1 by 100, how you can write this? 1 by 100 means 0. First position is 1 by 10th position, next position is 100th position, so I can write there 1. So 0.01 is the answer. What I did? I can convert this 0.1 to 1 by 10, so 1 by 10 into 1 by 10, so 1 into 1 means 1, 10 into 10 means 100. So 1 by 100 means here we should write 1 in 1 by 100th position. So 0 point, this is 1 by 10th position, this is 1 by 100th position. Okay. So now below this we have given that, let us see its pictorial representation. Okay, so the fraction 1 by 10 represents the fraction, this 1 by 10, what it represents? One part of 10 equal parts. So this fraction 1 by 10 represents one part of 10 equal parts. What do you mean by 1 by 10? 1 by 10 means one part of 10 equal parts. The shaded part in picture represents 1 by 10. So here we will consider 10 equal parts. Okay. So this is first part, second, third, fourth, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and this is 10. So there are, consider these are 10 equal parts, and they are given here in textbook. This is shaded part. Means here in 10 equal parts, 1 by 10 what indicates? one part, this one part of 10 equal parts. So this shaded part indicates 1 by 10, because there are 10 equal parts, only one part is shaded. Okay. So now we know that 1 by 10 into 1 by 10. 1 by, here we represented only 1 by 10. 1 by 10. And remaining is 1 by 10. So that 1 by 10 into 1 by 10 means 1 by 10 of 1 by 10. Listen carefully. First we represented this 1 by 10. No. Okay? Means 1 part of 10 equal parts. But remaining again 1 by 10 is there. So 1 by 10 into 1 by 10 means this 1 by 10 of 1 by 10. How to represent? So divide this 1 by 10th part into 10 equal parts. Take one out of it. So what I will do? Here we have 1 by 10. So again we have to divide this 1 by 10. So what I will do here? Again I will make 10 parts here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. So now again this is 1 by 10. So 1 by 10 into 1 by 10 into 1 by 10 of 1 by 10. So here this is 1 by 10. First there are 10 equal parts. First we represented one part, means this is 1 by 10. Again in this we have to represent 1 by 10, means we are making 10 parts here. So 1, 2, 3, continuously here we have 10 parts. So here in this 10 parts, we will represent only one part. Out of this 10 part, we are representing only one part. So this is the part. 1 by 10. Okay? Listen carefully. This 0.1 into 0.1 can be written as 1 by 10 into 1 by 10. So this 1 by 10 can be represented here how? One part of 10 equal parts. Here there are 10 equal parts, means 10 columns will mark one part of these 10 equal parts. But here they have given 1 by 10 into 1 by 10. So again we should consider this 1 by 10. So here 1 by 10 into 1 by 10 means 1 by 10 of 1 by 10. So this is 1 by 10, this is shaded part, 1 by 10 value. And again we have to mark one part of these 10 parts, 10 equal parts. So here we make 10 equal parts, and out of these 10 equal parts we are marking only one part. Okay? So this square, this shaded square, in textbook they have given dotted square, or you can put dot also here. This square is one of the 10 of 1 by 10 part, that is it represents 1 by 10 into 1 by 10. So this is representing 1 by 10 into 1 by 10 or 0.1 into 0.1. So how many small squares do you find in figure? So how many small squares are there here? First we made 10 equal parts, and after this again we made 10 rows here. Means there are totally 100 small blocks are there. You can count in textbook. How many small squares do you find in figure? They are given that there are 100 small squares. Here there are 100 small squares are there. So the dotted square represents 100 or 1 out of 100. So this dotted square, what it indicates? Only one square is dotted, means this indicates one out of these 100 squares. There are totally 100 squares. This dotted square, what it indicate, what it is indicating? One square of out of 100 squares. So here you can write it as one square of out of 100 squares. So 1/100, this can be written as 0 point, this one should be written in 1/100th position, so 0 1, because this is 1/10th position, this is 1/100th position. So 1/100 means what you get here also, you got 0.0 only. Here also directly you got 0.0 only, and here pictorically you got 0.0 only. Okay, and below this they are given another method which is very easier than these two steps or methods. So note that 0.1 occurs two times in the product. In 0.1 there is one digit to the right of the decimal point. See here, I will write it here. So 0.1 into 0.1. So after decimal point, after here, after this decimal point means right part of the decimal point. After decimal point means right part of the decimal points. How many digits are there? Here one digit and here one digit. Okay. So now we should add 1 + 1. Why we are adding 1 + 1? Here also one digit is there after one decimal point. Here also one digit is there after this decimal point. So 1 + 1 is equal to 2. Okay. So in product, when you multiply these two values, there should be two numbers or two digits after decimal points. So 0.1 into 1, we should multiply directly. 1 into 1 means 1, but here what we got? 2, means there should be two digits after this decimal point. So I will write here 0.1. So here also we got 0.01 only. So here directly we got 0.01, and here pictorially also we got 0.01, and here this is the easiest method. 0.1 into 0.1 means, listen carefully, only one digit is there. Here also one digit is there after this decimal point, so I will write here 1. So after this decimal point, again only one digit is there. So 1 + 1, what you get? 2. So in product, or when you multiply, there should be two digits after this decimal point. So 1 into 1, what you get? 1. And after this decimal point, there should be two digits, means before this one, you should consider 1 0, and before this point or decimal point, you should consider another 0. Okay. They are given another example. I will solve it directly. 0.2 into 0.3. Again you can see here, after decimal point, here one digit is there, and after this decimal point, only one digit is there. So 1 + 1, what you will get? 2. Okay. So what we got to know, when you multiply these two values, after this decimal point, there should be two digits. So 2 into 3 means 6. 2 into 3, 6. But here, after decimal point, we should get two digits, means before this 2, sorry, before this 6, I will consider 1 0, and I will put this decimal point, and before this decimal point, I will consider another 0. This is the answer, 0.06. So I hope you are clear with these examples. In next class, I will give some more examples on multiplication of decimal numbers, and I will continue with exercise 2.6. Thank you all.